It's grasshopper season in Uganda. Yep, that's the time of the year when these green insects turn up and swarm around bright lights. And it's a chance for many Ugandans to harvest them to eat. Here's more from DW's Julius Mugambwa.
The young ones are eating, and so are the adults, including uninvited guests. Many people in central Uganda have appetite for this long-winged and sharp-headed insect.
I can compare this with chicken, because it kind of has the same taste, and it's yummy.
If grasshopper season comes and my husband doesn't buy any for me, I may even leave home.
In Kampala, Eli Lubega suspended his vending work to earn an extra income from the lucrative trade in insenene, as grasshoppers are known locally. To meet demand, his entire household lends a hand in preparing the snack.
Compared to my other business, grasshoppers are a much more profitable venture.
Deep frying fresh grasshoppers for about 5 minutes makes them crispy. It also gives them a golden appearance. Lubega adds a bit of salt, spices them with fresh onions, and voila! Scientists have found grasshoppers to be exceptionally nutritious. Several studies propose that these insects may possess more protein content than some animal sources like chicken, beef, or fish.
Yes, insects are a viable option, especially in societies where they are treasured. For example, grasshoppers are treasured here in the central region. So if you find a society where the insects are treasured, it's they could be farmed and they could provide, they could bridge a gap in terms of the nutrition source.
Green campaigners are optimistic about insect diets because they are said to be low on greenhouse gas emissions compared to animals and poultry. Environmentalists are now looking at insects as possible alternative food sources for the sustainability of our planet. So, can Uganda's appetite for grasshoppers inspire you to add insects on your menu this festive season? Bon appetit.
Joining us now is someone who's done extensive research on insect consumption, Dr. Newton Matandirotia of the Center for Climate Change Adaptation and Resilience in Beitbridge, Zimbabwe. Welcome to the program. Can you give us a picture of how widespread the consumption of insects is on the continent?
Thank you very much, Tommy, for the question. Edible insects have been in the diet of Africans for a long time, and it is part of our diet as Africans. It's not something which is new. It has been in our traditional diets for some time. Therefore, it's not something which is coming up now. However, due to a lot of pressures in terms of food shortages, edible insects are becoming something which is being advocated for as an alternative in terms of replacing the other diets, like for example meat-based diets, the other sources of food, and the other diets. So edible insects, they are a very good option in terms of replacing what people are already consuming, and the pressures which are coming due to climate change and the wars around the world, which are resulting in food shortages. So I would say edible insects, they have been part of the African diet for a long time.
And we're talking about them as meals or as snacks. Are we saying that they should, you're suggesting they should become more prominent part of daily meals?
Why do we say they can be a very good alternative? It's because of their nutritional value. They do contain a lot of the nutritional content which is required by humans on a daily basis. For example, we are talking about proteins, we are talking about micronutrients, we are talking about vitamins. And they, such examples of these edible insects include grasshoppers, crickets, weevils, and here in the Southern Africa, we're talking about mopane worms. And besides being a source of the rich nutritional content, these edible insects also do have, can also act as a very good source of livelihood in terms of income generation for communities, particularly the women. So these edible insects, they play a very big role in terms of the nutrition content, the environment, contribution to the environment, positive contribution to the environment. And also in terms of their carbon emissions, they do have, in terms of their production, the value chain for edible insects is very, it's very low in terms of carbon emissions. Therefore, it's a very good source of food.
Just wondering, just picking up on that last point you mentioned there about their contribution, what about if they are being harvested? Would there be any knock-on effect on the chain? The sort of if these aren't these insects, does that affect the food chain in the long run? If we then start to harvest them in at a large scale,
basically most of the edible insects within the African region, they are seasonal in nature. Therefore, some of them they only appear in summer. Some of them appear in winter. Therefore, they follow a cycle. For example, if we take, for example, the mopane worms or the grasshoppers, the crickets, they only mostly appear in summer in the Southern Africa region, even in the Eastern Africa region. Therefore, in terms of their cycle, it follows seasonal patterns. So in terms of how we have been harvesting them, mostly it has been based on their seasonal appearance. And people have not really been rearing them as a source of food. Mm. However, due to the advancement in terms of farming techniques, methods have been devised which they've come up with ways to rear them on a domestic basis, away from them being wild. Okay. Because most of the harvest now is happening in the wild, but due to the advancement in techniques, farming techniques, these are now becoming domesticated. And we can say this is a positive move in terms of availability and in terms of how they can enhance nutrition and their food availability on the African continent.
Right. I remember many years ago in Nigeria eating fried termites. Have you eaten any insects, or do you actually include this in your diet?
Yes. Yeah, at the moment in the Southern Africa region, we do have termites. It's the termite season, and people are busy catching the termites. And along the highways, along the ways, you see women selling them, and it's a good snack, and people enjoy it, and it's part of the diet.
Okay. Dr. Nathan Dirotia, bon appetit, and thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much, Tommy, for the opportunity. Thank you.